big welcome to everyone. Today's layout is all about the relationship that my beautiful Snowy has with my two children. Now, Snowy came into our lives when Orlando was about 1 year old, and he has a very special relationship with Orlando, but the relationship he has with my daughter Victoria is very different. With Orlando, he has a more what I would call a brotherly relationship. They play together, they enjoy each other's company, they get into trouble together. But with Victoria, he has taken on of a more protective role, and I keep saying to myself that he acts more like a parent with Victoria. And there are times when if she's been naughty and she's in trouble, he will actually come and stand between her and me as if saying, you stop it, you back off. And I always wonder if I ever went to smack her in front of him, if he would actually have a go at me. I would like to hope not, but he actually thinks that I have no right to discipline my own daughter. It's quite funny, but that's the relationship he tends to have with her. So for my background paper, I'm going to choose that gorgeous red colour paper there, and it's got all the doggies, and that is from Eco Park, and it's from the I Love My Dog collection, and that paper is called the 4x6, sorry, not 4x6, 4x3 journaling cards, and obviously I'm using side B because I'm not using the journaling cards, but don't worry, I did buy two of each paper, so I will be able to use the journaling cards on the other side on some future layout. And then for the second paper, that's the 4x6 journaling cards paper, and obviously I'm using side B again because I love that gorgeous blue color. And most of this layout is being dictated by the colors in the photo. So if you look at the photos, my son is wearing a Spider-Man's outfit, and that's a lot of blue and red, and my daughter's just wearing jeans and a white top, and of course Snowy is a white lab. So the papers that I chose were the reds and the blues because it went really well with the colours in the photo. And what you see on screen is basically the layout as it is. The photos, where they sit is where they stay. And then I picked this gorgeous paper. Now, this paper is called Puppy Love, and of course, I'm going to do some fussy cutting. I just love these little circles with their little doggy faces on it. So I got out my scissors, and do not stress, I'm not going to bore you with a whole lot of fussy cutting, but if you know me, I do find fussy cutting relaxing, and it does tend to de-stress me, so I'm always in for a bit of fussy cutting. So I cut it out. I think in total I cut out about 16 of these little faces, and I just slide them vertically on the vertically or diagonally? Diagonally, vertically. Oh my gosh, horizontally. My brain's not working. Anyway, you see it for yourself on the layout there. And then in my stash, I have this gorgeous little stamp. It's of a little tag, and I do some journaling. Now, for those interested, the journaling reads, Snowy is the most patient dog on the planet. So, of course, now I'm playing with the ephemera. The ephemera is also from the Eco Park I Love My Dog collection. And I love that little tag there. And the little tag, the little blue tag says, love is a four-legged word. Yes, it is a four-legged word. And I also picked the centerpiece there of the ephemera, and that little red tag says, you are pawsome. I love the play on words. It's so funny. Well, I think it is. Or maybe just small things amuse me. Who knows? And then I found the other little ephemera. It's a oval, and it says, hashtag number one dog. And, of course, that's exactly what we think of Snowy. He is the number one dog. For us, he's the best dog in the world. So basically, the layout is, as you see it on the screen, this layout came together very quickly. And that's very unusual for me because I'm a very, very slow scrapper. It's not unusual for me to spend a whole day on the layout, you know, 3-4 hours minimum. I change my mind a lot. So what you see on the screen, nothing has been adhered to the paper yet because I have learned from experience not to adhere anything down until I'm 100% that is going to be the final layout, because I have a tendency to change my mind at the very last minute and make a mess of things when things are stuck down. So the little tag that you see in my hand now that I stamped myself, it took me a while to decide on a placing for it. I was undecided, but I knew that I was definitely going to use it on my layout. So this is where you see me now. I'm just going to start adhering everything down, because basically I knew this is exactly how it was going to stay, and everything is glued down now, and it's once again trying to find a home for that little stamped tag, and that's where it goes and that's where it stays. So just going to stick down the rest of the bits and pieces, and this layout is complete. Oh no, it's not. I've made a liar of myself. I did forget, I added some brads. Now these brads have been in my stash for a very long time, and it is my mission to use them all up at some point in time, because they're just taking up space and they're pretty much some very old items there. So I picked some brads that I thought coordinated quite well with my layout, and I just used my little pokey thing from Tim Holtz. I don't know what that thing's called, a little piercer. Let's call it a piercer, okay? Is anyone else like me that just gives everything its own names because I can't remember all the technical names of things, so I just call them whatever I want to call them. I'm going to call that little thing a piercer now. So I'm putting my little brads through, and the layout is complete, really. There's not much to it. So take this opportunity to thank everyone for watching and for supporting this small channel, which I hope grows one day. And if you haven't already, I would love it if you subscribe to my channel and also hit the bell notification so you are notified whenever I do upload videos. I hope everyone is well during these crazy times that we are living in, and I look forward to seeing you all again in the near future. So here are some close-ups, and there is some still photos at the end so you can actually see some close-ups of my work. Thank you all so much. Take care, everybody. Bye.